Alrighty, I've got water, I've got snacks. Been a while. I know I was supposed to be kind of streaming The Last of Us, but in all honesty, I don't think I'll be going ahead with that series on here, purely because, I'm just not entirely sure it's a kind of a fun one to stream. It's kind of one of those games that I think I enjoy more when I just play it in total silence or, like, with, a friend in the room. So, without a co-host, I might not return to that. Or at the very least, what I might do is, like, I don't know. I might return to it with a co-host, and if I do return to it, I'll probably be starting again from scratch. And so, instead, I'm going back to a different game that I haven't played in a while, because I kind of burned myself out on it, honestly. But now it's like, this is the exact same save and the exact same spot that I left off on last time. But as a recap, Cal took down an Inquisitor on Kashyyyk, and he now has to go back to Dathomir. So this is kind of another series I started mid-pandemic, and I never quite finished it. Because, like I said, I kind of got burned out on it. So that's what I'm here for today. I'm going to finish it. I believe I'm already on Dathomir, considering what I have Cal in. I don't. Yeah, Dathomir. Holy shit, I really am actually just dead ass in the exact same spot that I left off on. I remember, like, looking at this monstrosity right before I, stopped. I think Seer wants to talk, so I'm gonna turn off my mic for a second so you can hear some exposition.
Cal, do you have a moment? You've come a long way since Bracca, but the path is far from over. I want you to know the difficult challenges ahead.
I can handle it.
I know what you can do. I'm not denying that.
And I know what has to be done. I've done it before.
Cal, even the strongest of Jedi.
I'm not Trilla. I'll be fine.
I know you're not. I didn't say that.
I'm not asking you to say anything. It's okay, Seer. Really.
Just be safe, Cal. That's all.
Hey, I know we haven't been on great terms, but can I talk to you about something? I need your help.
I'm listening.
I've reconnected with the Force, but I still feel blocked.
Why do you think that is?
Every time I open myself up, I see Master T'Pol.
You felt this, yet you've continued deepening your connection to the Force. You know what that says to me?
That I don't know what's good for me?
That you're strong enough to embrace your emotions. Give yourself time.
Seer, thanks for helping me. It means a lot. I never knew much about Dathomir.
Not surprising, very few did. Most of what I know is from Cordova. He had his reasons for coming here.
Seems like it.
Doesn't mean it's safe. Be careful, Cal.
Okay. That's about all we kind of get out of her, if I recall correctly. Otherwise, it's just some, like, slightly to mildly generic dialogue. Which you can kind of get from her on any planet, really. The real question is, have I changed my lightsaber to red while I'm on this planet? Oh yeah, that's the stuff. Okay, so full disclosure, I do not remember the controls at all. And also, as a reminder, this is on story mode. I know I said this in like previous parts, but like I said, since it's been a while, I might as well do a slight PSA on the whole thing. Yeah, Cal, don't you pout at me. I am talking. Do you find my commentary disturbing or something? Yeah, that's what I thought. Little ginger fuck. But anyways, yeah, it's on story mode because I kind of just wanted to show you the story. This is like a mostly narratively based channel when it comes to playthroughs, except for Resident Evil. I'll still play that on like standard instead of casual because, I like playing those games on those difficulties, and normally when I play them on casual, it's like private. I'm blowing off steam. Sometimes it's nice to just go through Resident Evil with a fucking rocket launcher and just see what happens. fuck around and find out. And, you know, I'd probably do that on stream, again, if someone else were there, just kind of mess through, really, or just to kind of see optimally what is, like, the fastest I could get through the game without speedrunning, basically. Alright, I'm gonna try and kill this dude just as oh. That's not normally what happens. Did the update mess things up? Because I know this was optimized for PS5 recently. Is, like... Or is story mode just, like, killing the AI? They actually nerf story mode? Oh my god, if they nerf story mode, I'd actually be a little bit annoyed, because I feel like... I don't know. Oof. Which one was block? Oh, who needs block when you can just push him off the edge, am I right? Well, alright. I forgot that I upgraded force push pretty much all the way for that to happen. I probably should learn what block... Okay, it's L1 for block. Good to know. I'm gonna level with him. I don't know what I'm doing on this planet. I forgot. I guess that's what happens when you leave a game for nearly a year. But hey, on the plus side, what I call that is the game has really good replayability. So that's what I'm gonna chalk it down as. Okay, you know what I think I gotta do? I gotta head over to... I nearly gave away a spoiler, because surely if you're here you haven't played this before, or maybe you have and you're just curious about some other chucklefuck on YouTube trying to play Fallen Order. I have to head over to where we saw the hooded guy the first time that we were here, because I think I did come here straight off the bat just so I could get the lightsaber upgrade. So yeah, there's that. So yeah, I've got to go to the, Oh yeah, I kicked down the shortcut. But what I've got to do is I've got to head to... It's like a castle entrance. Little castle entrance that we kind of saw from the ship earlier. We're heading that direction, kind of. It is also worth noting, I do not know the map like the back of my hand. Arkham City, on the other hand, oh, different story. Okay, there's usually, yeah, two dudes here.
No, outsider!
Okay. In case you're wondering why I went red for this planet, again, I might have explained it in other parts, but... in the event that I have not. Darth Maul himself is actually from Dathomir. He's a Zabrak from here. He's not a Knight Brother necessarily. Oh my god, what is happening with this game today? That's not on me getting, like, hit. I was referring to the dude on the left over here. Just like... too lazy to T-pose, sort of thing. Okay. I'm experiencing a little bit of lag. I assume that is coming from the update for PS5 optimization thingy. So the update's probably all confused, being like, oh hey, this isn't a PS5. So yeah, I'm dressed for the occasion, so to speak, you know, just a teeny tiny Jedi heading through Dathomir in all black, just to, you know, fit in with the other goth boys with the red lightsaber to, you know, honor their predecessor of Darth Maul. Don't know why I did that. I think I was trying to hit square, hit options instead. I am so sorry.
Ah!
won't fail you, brothers.
He will fall before us. Wait for him to fall.
Shit. That's not my finest moment.
I will avenge them all.
Come on. Just shoot me already. Yep. What did we learn?
You fear our might.
Okay, that's that taken care of. I can now do this in peace. Oh yeah, it's a wall run, not a double jump. Cool. There we go. And we're back here. I think I did a full circle, like, you know, an idiot. Unless this opens. Oh, it does open. Again, I'm getting parts of the game mixed up now, because obviously you have to return to certain areas after a long period of time. New objective added to holomap. Yeah, so I do have to go here. Alright. Some cool shit's about to happen, so I'm gonna shut my mouth for a little bit.
Climbable, but not without equipment.
Die! You'll rot in the swamp!
I really dislike the sliding mechanic in the later parts of the game, not gonna lie. Although it kinda reminds me of like one of the old Harry Potter games on PlayStation 1 where you had to do like the flu powder thing and you're just like falling down this chasm into nothing.
You sure know how to have fun.
Okay, this is probably one of my favorite maps in the game. It's infuriating as hell, but I really, really like it. I think I have enough to mess around with the skill tree a little bit. So what am I missing? Oh, I'm still missing quite a lot. I've actually still got quite a level curve to go for. 3 skill points to increase all lightsaber damage. I mean, I could increase my health, like, right now. But I got, like, 3 skill points to play with. Let's see what I have to work with. Whirlwind throw, improved dash, repulse. I don't really use any of those. The throw is pretty neat. It'll come handy later. But not currently. Force attunement, max force is increased. Grasping pull. Nah, man, I wanna work my way toward... Actually, you know what? Oh my god, I actually literally have enough to get all the pull points. It's fate. Unless I suck at maths, which also a possibility. Nope, we're good. That's gonna be fun. I forgot, like, just how satisfying the later force powers are in this game. Alrighty. Do I need to rest? I mean, it resets all enemies. Then again, I'm at the bottom of the fucking pit. What am I gonna reset? A single spider? Let's go. Alright, alright, alright. Hehehehe.
You will go no further.
Stand aside.
No. He was right about you.
Who? What?
Jedi are thieves and selfish liars who bring nothing but death.
Back off. If you attack me again, I'll strike you down.
Oh, I won't do a thing. But my murdered sisters. They will have their revenge.
Something interesting?
We're undead.
So
leave
I thought
this place.
I thought the addition of the undead Night Sisters was a really, really cool. It was just a really, really cool addition for this game. Considering, like, this era is, like, I feel like this game is supposed to be like, this is the death of the Republic, and obviously the rise of the Empire, as seen by, like, the start of the game, when you see the Venator being torn apart, a Venator being one of the Republic frigate ships from like the Clone Wars era. But on top of that, I kind of just like how the game doesn't just reference the Clone Wars era, they reference just, you know, they just deadass reference the Clone Wars TV show. The Undead Night Sisters, that was like a legitimate thing. It was a whole arc on the TV show where I kind of don't want to spoil a TV show. I mean, I know I'd just basically be spoiling a show that's been out for years, but I feel like it kind of has new life now that the final season is out nearly a year now. I think it has been out for a whole year now.
How does that Night Sister keep following us? Sierra called them force wielders, and I've never seen it used this way before. We better stay on our toes. Wait, do you have toes? Any idea what that flying creature is? Let's hope we don't find out.
Oh, yeah, shortcut made. I'll just take it back up. Yeah, this just brings me back down here to... Yeah. Yeah, it's where we started, right over there. It's where we crawled through. It's the door I couldn't open earlier. Despite having a fucking lightsaber. But I'm not here to bitch about that today. You know, no one ever accused Cal of being smart, so we're not about to start. Okie dokie.
Night Brother runes. Think we're getting close to a village?
Fail you, brothers!
Good god, I forgot how satisfying the pull is in this. Gamma. One more. That should do it. Don't get shy on me now. Oh, they stopped getting shy. They stopped getting shy. Oh, hey, Sean. How's it going?
Mind tossing me a stim?
Okay, now, which way is the way forward? I think the reason that I kind of like this part of the map so much is because it's everything that I love and hate about certain horror aspects of, like, horror games. For instance, I really hate being in the sewers in Resident Evil, but because I love horror games, I fucking love being in the sewers in Resident Evil. You know, it's, I don't know, it's a weird dichotomy. Am I just... straight up just supposed to double jump to... Okay. Ideally, I'm supposed to be up there. Can I just... Oh, there's a little teeny tiny path here. Can I just, like, straight up jump to that? Or... Nah, that's... Yeah. That... Suddenly the double jump doesn't feel as... Oh, okay. There we go. Alrighty, I'm not gonna rest just to get the stim back, because I know we're gonna be getting another save point soon anyways. I'm gonna save that skill point for later, though. I'm just gonna meditate here to... Yeah, okay. Just, like, meditating and then not hitting the rest button will ensure that you have a save point to come back to, but you... won't reset any of the enemies. That guy there was just, like, scripted to be sitting his ass there. Because otherwise I'd just, you know, get the stim back. Okay. So I could jump down there, but is there anything over here? Is that just the way back? Oh wait, no, jumping down there is where I came from. This is the way forward. Duh.
Turn back, Jedi.
Nah. Oh, this suspiciously looks like a boss arena. Hi. Yeah, I forgot that they have, like, one last move before they die. Reminds me of, like, playing COD back in the day, and they had that, like, what was that perk called where you drop the grenade when you die? Fucking martyrdom. I used to hate that thing.
Let me see.
set an example.
Okay, now we're gonna have to pull this thing through. Oh yeah, I can actually see the little platform up there. I think another reason I like this particular part of the map is, I don't know, it kind of reminds me of Shelob's Lair from Lord of the Rings, you know, giant spider bitch. I am a huge arachnophobe, but I also kind of... I don't know. I was so interested in that particular part of the Two Towers book, and or Return of the King film, if you watch the films. I don't know, it's just, it really interested me because it was the one time where in fiction I
where the Night Brothers live.
Desperately, like, feared
we have no other choice.
For the main character, you know, or at least for what the story dictated was, like, one of the main characters and the whole purpose of the quest, where, there's a point where, like, Frodo, like, people think Frodo's fucking dead, you know? And I just found that rather enticing as, like, an 11-year-old who probably shouldn't have been reading Lord of the Rings. So this this part of the game, I felt, not only did it reflect the physical place of Shelob's Lair itself, I feel like it kind of reflected how it looked in the video game of Return of the King. I remember really hating that level because it was, I mean, for... I don't know if anyone who was like, you know, an adult playing that game, but as a child I had like a lot of difficulty with it. I mean, I loved it. I couldn't wait to get to it when I was playing the game the first time. But, I mean, as an adult, I fly through that level completely. But... excuse me. As like an adult, I fly through that level quite easily. But I don't know if that's a thing of, oh, I'm older, wiser, I know how games work, and it's an old game... Old game, easy, you know, I'm not getting at that at all. Like, I think personally it might come from a place of, I've just played the game so goddamn much that...
Good job, Edie.
I've just played the game so goddamn much that I just kind of know how to beat the boss and, like, get through the map. Like, that is, like, that Return of the King game... Other than maybe Resident Evil 4, is the game that I have played the most. Not even in my childhood, maybe in my entire life.
I'd say these vines are too creepy for Grease, but he's Grease.
So yeah, like, and actually, yeah, it does need a remaster. Actually, those Lord of the Rings games in general need a remaster or a remake of some description. I'm so ready to jump into more Lord of the Rings. And now, like, Gollum's getting a fucking game, which will be interesting. Wouldn't have been my first choice for a Tolkien-themed game. But am I still gonna play it? Yeah, absolutely. I don't know where I'm going. I'm actually literally running in circles. I think this is a part where I'm supposed to, like... pull something out of a wall run it, and then, like, jump up. Kind of looks like that sort of area. We get to climb those rocks later with a climbing tool. It's all very uncharted. It's very fucking cool. And then you get, like, this, like, super climb. Oh, here we go. I think I can latch onto this. Nope, never mind. I'm an idiot. I forgot what I was saying. Oh, yeah. I'm still gonna play the hell out of that Golem game, though. It seems like an interesting idea. Because, like, Golem is also a character in those, like, in that series, who I just found very, very interesting. And a very, in the literal sense of the word, a pathetic character. You know, you can feel sorry for him. He's still an evil bastard twisted by, you know, power and the idea of power and just this object that it manifested itself in. But, I don't know, if you can kind of... Oh my god, it'd be so cool to kind of see the three books and or films from the perspective of Smeagol. Or if you go through, like, even, like, The Hobbit, you can go through kind of, like, each different age that Smeagol lived through. I would eat that shit up so quick.
Another one of those things.
Haha! Missed me that time, motherfucker.
This was an arena once. The Knight Brothers only respect those with power.
Remember that fine detail for later? It pays off in a very cool way. Okay, now that guy's taken care of, I can have a look around. Never mind. Now I can have a look around. Or did I just jinx it again? Okay. But yeah, my main point was this whole section just reminds me so much of not only Shelob's Lair, but like Cirith Ungol. I think it's pronounced Kirith Ungol. Kirith. I always said Cirith, that's how I read it in the books, but in that Shadow of War game, they refer to it as Kirith. And who am I to disagree with something that was consulted by, like, the Tolkien estate of what is and isn't fucking pronounced right in Lord of the Rings? So, and even then, I think I've been saying Shelob, but it's Shelob. Like, she gets the whole hard O, I guess. So yeah, it's kind of weird how things translate differently between reading and watching, I suppose, because, I don't know, you get a different experience when you're reading it because obviously different characters have different voices in your head compared to, you know, what they'd have in a movie, and same goes for looks. Okay, this part drove me insane when I first played it. I think you come back here. Like, the way I have to go for now is literally just up here, I think. But it took me forever. And I'll show you what you have to do. It took me forever. I was stuck down in this hole.
To call their leader mother. She used powerful magic.
Oh, so Cal referred there to Mother Talzin? I mean, the Night Sisters referred to their leader as Mother in any case, whoever that leader is at the time. But since the Night Sisters are basically extinct now, he's referring to Mother Talzin, I think. Just, you know. But anyways, that's neither here nor there. I'm going to show you how to do this fucking stupid... I mean, it's not stupid. It's actually very clever. I'm just an idiot. So, which button was it to slow time again? Okay, yeah. So, that's what you had to do that whole time. Now, you basically just have to do that, but not shit. Get the buttons mixed up. But yeah, what I was doing was I was just force pushing and trying to get on the goddamn thing. And I said to myself at the very start of the game, oh, slow time, when the fuck will I ever use that? Well, guess what? I went the whole game pretty much without using it. And then I got stuck down here for like half an hour. Half an hour real time, half an hour of my life. Because I forgot about a force power from the start of the goddamn game.
My blows will fight. Our brother foe. He's hurt. We will end you. It's nothing. You could match me.
Yeah, it does kind of remind me of Tomb Raider, Sean. Actually, the whole game kind of does. It actually reminds me of the new Tomb Raiders, which kind of took a lot of inspiration from Uncharted, which took a lot of inspiration from the original Tomb Raider. It all comes full circle. Actually, that's another game that I... It's a series I want another game from is Uncharted. Like, I know Uncharted 4 is meant to be, like, the end of the story, but, like, hear me out. It's just the end of Nate's story. You know, I would happily play as, you know, other characters in that franchise. Like, there are very few characters in that franchise that I'll actively say that I hate with a passion, you know? Which was better? I mean, I've got a soft spot for Tomb Raider, man, but Uncharted just knows how to do story. Like, Amy Hennig... Amazing fucking storyteller. She is a woman who's been working in video games for like her entire career, I would imagine, and just it shows, man. Like, she's just really, really good at storytelling. And like Naughty Dog as the developers would like say, we want a section that takes place in a boat. We need some really ridiculous shit to happen because, you know, it's a video game. And she'd find a way to incorporate that into the game as a story element and have it not be ridiculous. Like, fuck me, that was just some really, really good game design on her part, for starters. But like, Christ, just man, oh man, just those Uncharted games are amazing. You know what? Again, like, they're the guys who made The Last of Us.
Death awaits you here.
What I might actually do, I might uninstall The Last of Us from my PlayStation. I might actually, after this game, do some Uncharted, because I actually haven't played Uncharted in quite a long time. The last time I played Uncharted was, like, the fourth one with my friend Laura. And that was ages ago, you know. Pretty much, I think it was the year that it came out. Fuck. Actually, no, because the last time I would have played it would have been Lost Legacy. Very, very cool DLC for that game. Which is basically its own game. In fact, it got its own... It was so big that it got its own release. Where you play as Chloe and Nadine from... Nadine from Uncharted 4 and Chloe, she was first introduced in the second game. Amazing character. And if any of you guys are into the Dragon Age games, she played Morrigan. Very, very cool character in that game, too. That's another game that I would love to stream here too, but like those games are long. Like those games are fucking. Oh wait a minute, what's this thing down the bottom right? I think that's the thing that you need like 4 points for. Personalized stims. Cal recovers additional life when using a stim canister. I guess that could come in handy later, but I guess, like, I mean, I'm on story mode, I don't really need to worry about getting hit too much, he says, right before going into a battle where he's probably gonna get hit a lot. Precision evade, when performing a precision evade, Cal briefly slows enemies and recovers a small amount of force. I'm gonna need that more than the actual full amount of force Cal can have at one point. So I think I'm gonna take that, because I dodge a lot, like, which you probably notice, probably too much. I probably do dodge way too much, but, you know, such is life. Alrighty, onward, I guess. So yeah, I guess I have kind of a plan now, because, like, again, I love The Last of Us. I love those games immensely, but I just don't think I can stream them. I just don't really have anything interesting to say. There's a lot of dialogue that I don't like to cut across, and then I feel bad for cutting across it. And then there was a point in that first playthrough that I was doing where I was playing a lot of it with one hand, because I was moderating my chat at the same time, trying to work out what the problem was there.
It might be dangerous.
So yeah, I ended up, like, bumping into walls quite a lot. Although, then again, I bump into walls generally playing it with two hands anyways, but yeah, I'm not ashamed to admit that I was playing that game with, like, one hand and my knee at one stage. Now, this is a monster design that I like a lot, because he looks a lot like Goliath from DC Comics, Damian Wayne's, like, pet bat thing. Damn. I messed up. It's like he has some very specific weak points.
Was a mistake.
I think it's gone.
Alrighty. What I was trying to say was he has some very specific weak points, his, like, wings, and then obviously his forehead, as you can see, had, like, you know, it started to crack the more you hit at it. See, now he climbs, like, way faster. Oh, shit. Well, sorry, Cal. Ooh. I feel really bad for his knees. I'm really glad that didn't take damage. Did it take damage? Haha.
You can't defeat me, tiny wall.
Oh man, this just makes me really miss climbing. Not that I've ever climbed with an apparatus like this that helped me climb faster, because I don't think one exists. But climbing in general, I really, really miss. Best core workout ever. Most fun core workout ever. Pretty scenery.
The strongest Night Brothers faced a rite of passage by venturing into the lair of this creature.
As you can tell, it worked phenomenally for the guy we just stole the fucking gear from. Alright, gonna rest because he's gonna need those stimmies. Okay. Oh, this is the gate that was locked earlier, I think. Yeah. Not that it matters now, because we could just jump straight to the cobble wall here. I'm sure it's called something else, but it looks kind of like grimy cobblestone from Minecraft, so that's what I'm gonna call it.
Stay low, buddy. Don't let it hit you!
Excellent advice, Cal. I never would have done that on my own. I honestly don't think I'd have figured that one out. Astute.
We're gonna die!
No. With that attitude, maybe. What in the hell? I pressed L2.
Here we go again!
The Sky Guardian on Kashyyyk was way nicer to me.
Jump again? Okay, I trust you.
I wish I could say the same for this creature, though. Having a good time, BD?
Oh, can I scan him? Thought I could scan him. Nope. Alright. Alrighty, gotta climb back up again. That is one thing that I will say about this game that's, like, mildly infuriating, is, like, oh, you come so far, and oh, you get knocked back down, oh, no. You know, there was a bit of that in Resident Evil Village as well, where I was just like, okay, cool, and we're back at the top, and, never mind. I just remembered I can actually climb the cobble wall now, so I can just go straight back over here. Well, that was stupid. You know, I'm just gonna let them sort this one out.
Your blows are weak.
Think you can match me?
Cannot hide your weakness.
Okay, bored. Slightly annoyed that I can't pull you off of that thing. Oh, never mind.
I must defeat him.
Now I'm satisfied.
You're mine, Jedi.
Into their village. Mm-hmm. I doubt they expected us to come back. Still, there's gotta be a stealthier way in.
Nah, be grand. Knock on the front door. They won't mind. Cal, I swear to God.
Honestly, I had no idea this was here when I pulled the bridge down. I just wanted to see what would happen. Like you and the cutter on Kashyyyk.
I don't think I've ever actually had this many frame rate drops in this game since... I don't know, it's been updated a whole bunch since I last played it. I honestly don't know what the problem is. Maybe it's my end, maybe it's just because, like, my PlayStation's old.
Too many. It's too dangerous. We should kill him!
No, we take him to Brother Vizis.
Okay, I don't climb through here. Oh, yeah. There was a turn. Not that it mattered. Can I push this? Nope. Hang on. My chat decided to just die. There we go. Alright, it's back. Wait, nope, frozen. Back. Sorry about that. Minor technical difficulty. Is there anywhere that I just sort of squeeze through, or... because that was my way over. Now, Cal places a lot of faith in, like... oh, here we go. He places a lot of faith in that tiny droid. Can't say I blame him. I would die for that thing. See, even on normal surfaces, you just, like, scale the fucking thing. I feel like the game just... the devs just sort of knew which point the, players would be like, hey, I'm kind of fucking sick of climbing. You know? So it's like, yeah, they're, like, halfway through the game. They can... we can afford to let them speed up the process just a smidge. You know how it is. Okay, I think I've actually got to jump down now. Ugh, better ruin this poor bastard's day. That's a non-blockable one.
You can't win, outsider! We can win, brothers! Brothers, aid me!
That escalated quickly. Ow. Okay, I'm not waiting for him to shoot again, I'm just gonna cap him. Never mind, there's no shortcut. Yeah, he can live. Tell his friends I said hello. Oh, big boy's coming down to play, okay. Okay, I respect that. Uh-huh. Okay, good thing I have double jump by this point, because that could have been awkward. Get over here! Oh, okay, so I can use this to climb something, I suppose. What I climb, I do not know. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds about right. Okay, this box can defy gravity. Okay, I can honestly say I don't think that's ever happened before. I'm gonna see if there's anything stuck behind that box where it was. Nope. No, heap and pile, nothing. Alright, let's go. Seems like the way forward. I think I put that in the right spot. Giggity. I deserve that. Come on. There we go. I'm gonna be exploiting that move a lot.
I grow tired of waiting for instruction from the sister. This intruder must be dealt with.
I'm just gonna see if this opens. Nope. Okay. No shortcut for me. And fuck that vase in particular. Which way was the way out? I feel like I walked by the way out several times, and yeah. Or is this where I came from? I think it was. Yep. Okay. I can live with that. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I literally stared at this earlier. Never mind. I love how the map actually does go full circle. Every map, for that matter. Because, like, anything that you can kind of see, like, any ground that you can see that's flat, you can sure as hell, like, walk on it. I find that just really, really fucking cool. And if you're at a certain angle, you can actually see your ship rendered, you know? Speaking of, I think I'm going to give that a paint job in a few minutes. I'll wait till I progress in the story first. Oh, hang on. Sorry. I'm reading comments, like I was reading comments off my phone. My phone fell. Could no longer see chat. Can now see chat. Oh yeah, no, Sean, the game looks phenomenal.
Cal, have you found the tomb?
Close, but got a little sidetracked.
Grease is acting strange. He swears he saw someone outside the mantis. Dathomir's getting to him.
Pretty sure that's who he is.
Are you alright?
I'm not seeing things, so... Yes? I'm coming out of a Night Brother village now. Hoping to get back on track.
Sounds like you're handling yourself.
Yeah, BD and I got this.
Oh yeah, Sean, the game does look phenomenal. I think my only problem with it, at least on PS4, from what I've personally experienced, is the textures render way too late. It doesn't impede my enjoyment of the game by any point, by any means. It's just that the, I'm just gonna stop here for a second to kinda say, articulate my point. Basically, the game plays so well that, like, the slightly off textures, like, don't bother me. Like, on PC, this probably looks fine. I think on Xbox 360, Xbox One and Xbox, like, Series X and that, apparently this is meant to look a lot better. I do not own an Xbox past 360, unfortunately, as much as I would like to play some Halo on that thing. But like, even look at the texture on the left. It's like blurred in places. It looks very painted on, almost like, kind of like Resident Evil HD remake. Well, Resident Evil 4 HD remake. Resident Evil 1 remake. Fucking phenomenal textures. But it doesn't impede my enjoyment at all, because the art style has a very clear vision right down to the, from the character models to just the end of that corridor, you know? Like, if you posterize this image, it'll look like concept art, and chances are this is something that someone has drawn. I mean, I know concept art is in this game, I haven't looked through it all yet. I would like to. I might do that at the end of this stream, as in, like, you know, when I finish the story. Maybe I'll finish the story in this stream. Who knows? It all depends on kind of when I get tired, really. And lucky for you guys, I don't really feel tired currently. Voice is a little hoarse, but, you know, other than that. But yeah, Sean, highly recommend getting this game. This is on PlayStation 4 for anyone who hasn't, anyone hasn't figured out. But it still plays very well. Another complaint that I have, that I didn't previously have, was the frame drops happen even just kind of now. It's like when there's more than like three, more than even two NPCs in one room, the frame rate just decides to drop like harder than like a ton of bricks, you know?
He shakes his beard. This pain means nothing. Stop him from moving. Strike him. Your defeat is assured. I do not fear.
Okay, that was fun. So yeah, like the frame drops when there's more than just like a couple of people at one time on screen, kind of annoying. I think it's more annoying. I just got a little bit of lag just now. I think the reason that it annoys me is just because like we didn't have this problem before. Unless maybe I did have the problem and I just didn't notice it before, but because it's been a while now, I'm noticing it. I don't know. Someone look back on earlier episodes and comment later and let me know if this was an issue with previous episodes. I don't remember it being a problem. I certainly don't remember it being a problem when I first played this. Or the second or third time I played this. You know, it's a weird one.
You cannot hide your weakness.
And now we're back to where we started.
Cannot defeat our might.
You there, come here.
Me? Oh, okay. Where are you at? You come here. And now that that's settled, this is where I came from.
Going to look.
I'm gonna look at the map. This is the first time I think I've looked at the map in the past while. Okay, so there is a clear path down. I just gotta go the right fucking way, I guess. Oh, yeah. Staircase. Oh, that opens. Yeah, I forgot. Again, like, it's gotten to a point in this game where I just see doors and assume they're fucking locked. It's the same with Resident Evil. I'll be like, oh, did I open this one?
I wonder if the Knight Brothers got him.
Brothers, an outsider! I hear Brothers! Eight! Dathomir thirsts for your blood!
Alrighty. Bye.
This must be the tomb.
But, yep, Sean, regarding what you're saying, I highly recommend this game, honestly. I think it's on sale currently on PlayStation Store, if you want to check it out.
We've reached the tomb of Kujet in search of an Astrium.
Whatever that was, it's gone.
Anytime.
Sounds good. On your way to training?
Always.
All right then. I'll see you later.
Bye.
I heard we're getting new orders soon. Finally. I'm ready to be gone from this dump.
We leaving Braca?
Possibly. Don't get his hopes up with secondhand gossip.
It's okay. I believe it once Master DePaul says so.
Speaking of your master...
Oh, yeah. I better go.
You know, Gyro isn't known for his patience. You're in a rush.
Master T'Pol's called me for training.
You got this, kid. We'll talk later.
Master T'Pol?
Padawan, it's time for instruction.
Yes, Master?
Reach our position. Do not keep me waiting. Good. Focus.
Were you concentrating, you would have anticipated this distraction. Better, Padawan. Join me.
Huh?
We'll begin with physical preparation. First, though, we have orders. Braca is secure. We move out from Mikito shortly.
Yes!
You must...
Astro, are you okay?
Something is...
No! No! What's happening? Why did the commander just...
Padawan, something terrible is happening. The clones have betrayed us. There are no answers to your questions. Not yet. We need to get off this ship. Quickly. Get to the escape pods. Use the maintenance halls. We trained for this. Do you remember?
Yes, Master. Well, what about you?
I will create a distraction and meet you. If I am not there when you arrive, depart without me. I will find you on Braca. Do you understand?
Yes, Master.
They're coming. I will seal the blast doors, but if any cross your path, do not hesitate. Go. And may the Force be with you. Go! Go!
There he is! Shoot to kill!
No! Stop!
DePaul's on the move. We're gonna need backup.
Need to pull that to get through. This doesn't make any sense. What's going on?
Do we have eyes on the Jedi? No sign of the little one. Search everywhere. We can't have gone far. Hands off again. Wait, what's that noise? Hold this room. I'll search the area. Reporting casualties. DePaul has taken out multiple squads. Shoot on sight. Copy that.
Dead. What changed?
What was that? Someone's in the maintenance halls.
I think I'm near the turbo lift. Not much further after that. Master.
We have to pull pin to the airlock. Send backup. Sorry, the pole was on the other side of that door. Yeah, but he won't be getting through. It's taken far too long to cut through these doors. What's that sound? Get ready!
Have to leave now.
The door controls.
spaceship's reactors. The explosion will mask our escape. This war is not over, my Padawan. Hold the line. Wait for the Jedi Council signal. Remember, trust only in the Force.
Yes, Master.
Okay, that glitch kind of ruined the moment, but, yeah. I'm just gonna pause here real quick and take a water break, but I will be back. The stream hasn't stopped, I'm just hitting the brakes for a second. I'll be right back. Okay, I am back. Sorry, just my throat was getting a little bit dry, so just needed some water. I am fine now. But yeah, I kind of wanted to stay silent for that part anyways, just cuz like the Order 66 not so much twist, we all kind of know what happens, but let me tell you, when I first played that sequence, I lost my mind cuz I didn't think they'd actually do it. Obviously, they talk about it because they talk about the Purge, and you see Purge troopers, and, you know, you're a Padawan. His whole shtick is he survived Order 66. So the fact that we actually got to see it from the eyes of a Padawan is fucking amazing, frankly. I thought it was awesome. Hope you guys thought so, too.
It's broken. The crystal shattered. Useless. Nothing.
So now we gotta head back to the ship.
Thanks. Let's just get out of here. I can't explain BD. Not sure I even understand.
He's not Koa's plan. I can't say I didn't warn you.
Leave me alone.
Leave you? Alone? Lost? And defenseless in this dangerous place? Never.
Okay, enough of this. Who are you really?
Taran Malakos. Former Jedi. Like yourself. We have much in common.
I doubt that.
Oh? We both survived the Purge. My troops betrayed me. I was forced to strike them down, and I escaped to this desolate place. To the darkness here. It almost took me. But I conquered it.
You're the one the Night Brothers follow.
Yes. Well, these savages only respect strength. And as we both know, the Force is a most powerful ally.
Oh, you use the Force to seize power. That's everything the Jedi stood against.
These are dark times! They will consume us if we do not stand with each other.
I don't need your help.
That broken lightsaber tells a different tale. You saw something in there, didn't you? Something terrible. There are many such places here in Dathomir. Join my family. I can teach you how to control its power.
Join my family, and I will teach you to control the power. Familiar words, Malakos.
Sister Merin, you overstep your bounds.
For years, you said the Jedi orchestrated the massacre that killed my sisters. Yet here one stands. And you seek only to bring him into your family.
You were told to deal with it. Clearly you lack the power, little witch.
Power? You are mad, Malakos. Dathomir has unmade you. And my misplaced loyalty has allowed you to lead the Night Brothers astray. Unlike the Jedi, the Night Sisters of Dathomir do not turn on their kind. Our bond is eternal.
Your sisters are dead!
Yes. Their graves are all around you.
Time to go.
Join us, Lamen. Taylorioliae.
Foolish girl! This power is beyond your control!
You both shall learn. When you face one Night Sister of Dothamir, you face us all!
Something here. Energy from the ruins?
Seer! Seer! Tell Grace to get the mantis running!
What's happening?
A Night Sister! She raised the dead! They're after me!
Whoa, whoa, whoa! And you're leading them here? Captain, prepare for takeoff!
I got dead witches crawling all over my ship!
Just go!
What happened? Did you find the tomb? Your master's lightsaber.
I saw him.
Master T'Pol, I saw the day he died. I saw what I did.
Cal.
Now it's destroyed. I couldn't save him.
Cal, you were only a child.
No, I know I could have helped him if I'd been stronger and braver, if I would have listened to him. I could have helped him. I know it.
Cal, it's time I told you everything that happened to me when I escaped the Empire. They brought Trilla in the room. And when I saw her eyes, they showed me what I had caused. She was an Inquisitor. And something in me gave. And I lost all control. And I tapped into the dark side. And I killed them all. Every last one of them. Except for her. And for years, I couldn't forgive myself. I was a wreck because I had all this rage. And I tried pushing it down, but there was no hiding from myself. And all I wanted to do was die. But then I learned about the Holocron. A spark of hope that there could be a future, that we could move on. Get up. I can't change what I did, no more than you can change what happened to your master. It's in the past, but Cal, you have to make a choice to move on.
How?
You're gonna start with this. You are going to build a new one.
Cal. You will be tested.
Yeah. But I'm ready.
I don't mean just here. Every Jedi faces the dark side. And it's very easy to fail.
You're still struggling with the dark side. Even after cutting yourself off from the Force.
You will always struggle. But that is the test. It's the choice to keep fighting that makes us who we are.
I guess it's about time I find out who I am.
Alrighty, before I head out into the wastes of snow, I just want to show you a really cool detail. They actually show you the wreckage of the saber itself. And, you can still change shit in it, that's kind of neat. I like this one. And as you probably guessed, costume change. Yeah, because it's broken, it won't turn on. He's just like, But yeah, Sean, if you're a sucker for the lighting, you are in for a treat for what comes next. But first of all, I'm gonna change some appearance stuff. How do I turn off Inquisitor, Cal? Appearance. Alright, I'm gonna change his flight suit. I like this one the best, Guardian. There's one that I'm missing, and I don't know what one it is, for the life of me. I'll find it someday. And, don't want him to get chilly. I like this one. Okay, let's go. Oh, and the terrarium seed. No, I was forgetting something.
Nice one on the seed collecting, but the terrarium still got plenty of room. So, you know, get out there and get me some seeds.
Sure, Grease. Whatever you say.
Okie dokie, let's bounce. Now,
it's been a while, but... Yeah. I remember. Every Jedi comes here as a kid. Or they did. When there were Jedi.
Yeah, I'm a sucker for snow physics and snow levels in games. This is one of my favorites, because, like, right down to the, like, footprints in the snow. And the snowfall covering them moments later. I mean, obviously they're doing that in a way it's like, oh, well, they can't just leave your footprints there permanently, so it's a way of, like, covering them without, like, making it seem like, oh, your footprints just disappear because video game, there. You know?
No, be careful with the ice.
Alrighty, now where do I climb from? It's not this part, is it? Oh no, it is. Okay. I'll take it. Is this where Force Echo was? Cobblewall. But yeah, regarding the lighting, I think this is one of the prettiest maps with the prettiest lighting. And you'll see once you get inside the temple exactly what I mean. Like, on next-gen consoles with the ray tracing and stuff like that, or even just on PC with ray tracing, I'm sure it looks phenomenal. I haven't seen it on PC, nor have I seen it on next-gen, but I'm looking forward to it. I'll get a next-gen eventually, just, you know, obviously not right now.
The great Jedi meditated here. He returned at points throughout his life to contemplate his many adventures and trials.
This actually is a really, really sweet detail. A fan of the game unfortunately passed away. If you guys don't know this already, this is actually a memorial to that fan. You see like a hat down there, I assume it's something that the fan used to wear. But yeah, I thought it was a really sweet detail for him to put in. I didn't intend on coming across this, I thought I was actually just going the right way. But, I'm kind of glad I came across it now. But it was very, very cool of the devs to put that in. I don't know whether the guy was a fan or, like, a friend of the dev team, someone who used to work for the dev team, but regardless, it was a really, really nice detail, which I liked a lot. I love it when games do that, when they kind of show appreciation that sort of way. It's, I wouldn't say it's less common. What I will say is it's just very, I don't know, it's really wholesome when you come by it.
Let me see.
Oh wait, forgot to do a thing. I'm used to just coming here on free roam mode once I finish the game, so all this stuff's normally already open and ready to explore. Now, this is what I mean, look at the lighting. It's like,
to be beautiful. The warmth is nice. Good job, BD. I remember this room. Master Yoda melted that door to let us into the caves. Not with the Force. With that crystal. The light passed through it and carried its warmth. I bet we can do it too.
Now, I forget where I'm supposed to slot this into. This is actually a really cool puzzle. It took a while for me to actually do the first time, the second time too, because, you know, I mean, I have a pretty good memory in general, but then when it comes to video games, it's just like, I mean, I don't need to tell you guys that. You've seen me play Resident Evil. Like, all of a sudden, semi-eidetic memory turns into, fucking goldfish territory. Oh, hang on a second. Now, this isn't for the way forward, but it can get me into that little area there. You basically gotta do the same thing here as that there, just with the other light source. I could just let go of this for the time being. Actually, I think I can use the swing over. Multi-purpose! Now, this here is actually another area that appeared in the Clone Wars. Again, when I saw this, I lost my shit, because, like, the Clone Wars, it might not be my favorite era of Star Wars, but the Clone Wars TV show is definitely one of my favorite, you know, definitely one of my favorite pieces of media that Star Wars has given us. I just like it a lot. So, this planet is called Ilum, which you probably saw from the opening when we first came through here. And, how do I get back up? Shit. I think I fucked myself. But, there's this... Hey, this is like the Crystal Caves. This is where all the Padawans go to get the crystals for their first lightsabers. And, in, like, there's an episode kind of dedicated to this. You see, like, a bunch of Padawans kind of go through here to, make their lightsabers. It's all very cool. I'll go into a little bit more detail once I finish the puzzle. I gotta get back up there to open up the other light source. I think I could just swing up there maybe with this. I mean, it's not the worst idea. Yeah, I feel like if I get enough momentum, I can just get back up. Nope. Yeah, don't worry, Cal. I'd be disappointed in me too. Oh, the droid sees something. Again, I'm probably just missing something painfully obvious at this stage. It's like, I know what I'm supposed to do, I just don't know how to get back up there. There is something I can do with this.
Magnifies heat from the light outside. Just need to get it in the right position, then open the window across from the waterfall.
Alright, so stuff that I already knew, I was hoping that they'd give me a hint how to get back up. Oh wait, I think I can actually force push that down from the other side. Maybe I can use that as a step up. Or maybe there's just like a separate path over here that will actually get me back to the thingy. To the ledge, even. Actually, wait a second. Can I pull that over here and, yeah, 'cause I'm done with that light source now. I might as well just, like... Just gonna put this here for safekeeping. Oh yeah, there's another rope here. Cool. I'm just stupid. Let's go. Good God. Okay, well, at least I know I can get back up now, so I think I just have this on the wrong side, maybe. Yeah, that looks a little bit more right. Okay. That's better. So, as you can see, that wall of ice just sort of melts, and in the episode where the younglings are going to find their crystals, that waterfall sort of thing, the ice wall, had like a time limit. It would slowly begin to freeze back up the longer that they took. So like the Padawans were obviously being like rushed to get a crystal. Okay, there's no need to rest. I just kind of wanted to save progress with that, so onward. Yes, Sean, like, snow levels in games are probably my favorite. I never get bored of them. So yeah, game devs, if you ever wanna just impress me for like zero reason and minimal effort, just like put in a snow level, or just set the entire game in snow. It's what kept me playing Skyrim for so long.
There's heat coming from those cracks underwater, but it's freezing up here.
Actually, you know what?
It's calling to me. We must be close. Jedi can't pick any Kuiper crystal. It chooses you. Yeah, kinda like you.
Actually, you know what? My favorite snow sequence in a game is in Dragon Age Inquisition. It's kinda like that moment that puts the player back in square one. You think you're gaining some semblance of power, and enemy just comes along. It's like the big bad just sort of comes along with his BDE and beats the crap out of all of your troops and you, and destroys your base, which is in like the mountains in the snow. And I shouldn't have fallen through that. It's like in the mountains in the snow, and so anyways, your base gets destroyed and shit, and you're just like wading through all of this thick snow, like thick with like 3 cubes. Of snow, and
close one.
You just kind of have to deal with it. you got like some new powers and stuff like that, and it's just your main character. The main character is just like at this one point of just like, yeah, I could just die, you know. It's like I could give up right now, and it's just like you meet up with your troops, and you know. You kind of have this moment of relief. Oh, thank fuck, none of you are dead. That would suck, you know? And it's just beautiful moment in a really, really dreary game.
It's them.
Fuck.
How did they find us here? Thanks for being here, BD.
Cool. It's just... the Dragon Age games are just such comfort games for me. I love them immensely. They're just highly recommend them if you're a fan of like any role-playing games, if you like The Witcher, even if you're just enjoying this. Narratively speaking, it has like similar cues to this game. I would argue it looks prettier, but that might be me being biased, just because like Dragon Age probably is my favorite role-playing game. Especially Inquisition, like, and I have kind of like a newfound love for Inquisition now that, I guess now that I've kind of played all of the games and all of the DLC. Actually, I'm missing one DLC. It's Jaws of Haken, in Inquisition, because I didn't get the Game of the Year version of Inquisition. I just got the standard release in HMV when it was shutting down here in Dublin. Because obviously, you know, anyone in the UK watching this is like, it's like, oh, HMV shutting down? Fuck no. Because that's straight up, you know, it's like HMV is still quite alive and well in the UK as far as I know. But over here, HMV is quite dead. And what the hell, Cal? HMV is quite dead over here. And I got Dragon Age Inquisition for like less than £5 in the sale, in like their closing down sale. And best £5 I ever spent. I didn't get the season pass because I just didn't know what I was expecting from the game, because I'd only really played the first one at that point. And even then, I hadn't played it all the way through. I watched people play it all the way through. But I think I actually played Inquisition for fuck's sake, Cal. I think I played Inquisition the first out of all of them all the way through. I didn't know what I was really getting into, so I didn't bother getting the season pass, because I was just like, I mean, £5 or less than £5 is like a sacrifice I'm willing to make to like try something from EA that was that new, you know, because EA is EA. And I guess the thing that sold me on the idea was because, shit, that was my bad, I'm just an idiot. I think the thing that sold me on Dragon Age in the end is that it's actually by the same people who made the Knights of the Old Republic games, and those are my favorite Star Wars games. Although I think Obsidian made the second one with BioWare assets. And, but anyways, that's neither here nor there. What I'm getting at is, like, Dragon Age Inquisition is just, like, one of those really, really wholesome games that I can kind of just pick up at any point and just, like, really, really not get sick of it ever, really. And, so yeah, the missing DLC that I have is just from... I knew that I needed the Trespasser DLC because that was the end of the game. So I knew that I kind of needed that one. And then the Descent was, like... on sale one time when I got it. I think I got the Descent DLC with the Trespasser one.
He was heading into the caves. He called out, but I couldn't find him.
I think I got the Descent DLC when I got the Trespasser one. But the one that I'm missing is Jaws of Haken, which is meant to be amazing as well. I'm kind of desperately waiting for that to go on sale again to get it. And again, I'd love to be able to kind of stream Inquisition for you at the very least, because firstly, I think it's just one of the most easily accessible Dragon Age games. It's one of the most like easily accessible RPGs. You could just like pick it up and it just explains so much right off the bat that you don't really need to know a lot going into it. And that's something that I really appreciate about most games, same as Resident Evil. You could jump into any one of them and not be lost, you know? Alrighty, now where the fuck do I go? So yeah, if there's anything to take from this rambling, play fucking Dragon Age. What are you doing with your life?
I can see it's shining.
Okay, before I crawl under there... Oh wait, no, that's for later. Duh, I forgot. Lightsaber broken. Sard broken. I was like, oh hey, I'm gonna check out this area real quick and get like the Force Echo in there, and I was like, oh yes, my whole purpose of being here is that lightsaber broken must fix.
It's through there. I can feel it. We're almost out of here. I promise.
Speedy, don't come any closer! Speedy!
Failure is not the end, my friend.
That's goodbye.
The time's come. This may be the last you see of me. I can sense the doom of the Jedi Order is upon us. No! Failure is not the end. It is a necessary part of the path. Hope will always survive in those who continue to fight. Like you, BD-1. I believe you will find someone just as brave and persistent as you have been. And you will help them as you have helped me. But your memory will be completely lost. Are you sure you want to do this? Beginning total memory encryption. Only with a trusted connection will your memories be restored. I believe in you, as I always have. And I believe in whom you choose to replace me. Friend.
Your memories. You risked them for me. Yeah, I believe in you too, buddy.
Thank you. don't like it.
Okay. There we go. Sorry, it's like, basically what happened there is, like, he merges the saber, his, like, master saber with Seer's one, and it's like, it's all very poetic. It's like, oh yeah, yeah, you can, you're like, it mirrors both of his masters, but, I'm sorry, Seer's switch looks, fucking awful. So, let's see here. I do want both of the emitters to look a little different, though, just for funsies. I really like that one. I really like that one as well, though. Let's make like a half Obi-Wan, sort of half Anakin sort of style saber. That'd be neat. The sleeve affects them both. Ooh, but the leather wrap in the middle does look pretty fucking epic. Yes, exactly. Pimp my saber. Yeah, this seems fine. That's better. Okay, let's bounce. Setback.
I heard Jedi.
You got this, BD.
Down there. Copy. Let's take him out. I'll get right behind you. I missed. He's too scared.
Calm me down.
I've got a contact under us. If you say so.
Identified.
integrity compromised. Still resisting? Online.
Finding great stuff.
Yeah. It's hard to look at these crystals after everything we went through.
Think you can handle this, Speedy?
So, here, we need to get out of here. Context. Taking over Ilum.
Are you all right?
No. They spotted me. And that's not all. They're mining Kyber crystals.
Captain, prepare for takeoff.
So, for context, these containers all contain kyber crystals, the things that we were kind of looking for to fix the lightsaber. Good droid. The idea here, for context, is that the Death Star from A New Hope uses kyber crystals to power its, like, super laser thingy. And this is where the Empire have been mining crystals to power the laser. Is this open? No, okay. Just this one. You know, I'm feeling pretty cocky, so I'm not gonna say progress.
Not sure if I saw movement.
Literally my favorite thing to do. Feels very Starkiller or something.
An intruder above.
Ooh, I'm after him. Big gun.
We'll win easy. Evade the blast bolts. Move in.
Thanks for doing my job.
Lighting up Imperial channels. They're sending everything they've got at you.
Are you in Greece safe?
We're laying low, but the storm's clearing. We won't have any cover soon.
Oh, did the droid see something?
I've sliced through their encryption. I'm scrambling transmissions, but it won't be long before they're restored. Hopefully it'll buy us some time.
Thank you. There's stormtroopers everywhere.
Ilum was our planet, Cal. Don't let them forget that.
Now I'm gonna say progress, because now I'm starting to feel just a little less cocky. Just a smidge, you know. I've also got 3 points to use up. Might as well spend them on, like, the all-in-one. Okay, that down the bottom right is recovers additional life when using a stim canister. See, that's handy and all, but I think I'd actually just rather mow people the fuck down, honestly.
Called reinforcements. Every Star Destroyer in the sector is on their way here. If they get here before you do.
No, we didn't come all this way to get captured. I'll be there.
Seer, we've got company. Tell Grease to close the Mantis.
What? With the Empire on your tail? Are you crazy, kid?
Trust me.
We do. We'll close the chip.
Oh shit, ran out of force. Oh, there's two of them. I forgot about that. Alrighty, that's taken care of. Now, where was I going? Oh yeah. The ship, that'd be a good idea, wouldn't it?
You did it.
We did. I wouldn't be here without all of you. I used to sit on Braca dreaming about storming Coruscant with survivors from the Jedi Council. Instead, the Order's hopes rest on a gambler, a fallen Jedi, and a failed Padawan. A bunch of screw-ups.
You can say that again.
Vidi's the only reliable one. He let Cordova wipe his memory so he could stay behind and guide us. But you're both willing to sacrifice everything. To keep going even when it seems impossible.
Failure's a part of the journey.
I get that now. Thank you. All of you.
Alrighty. Now let's get rid of the poncho. It's ridiculous. That's better.
Hey, wasn't there a gigantic crash ship on Zepho? Think there's any good loot in that thing?
Yeah, Grease. I'm not going back to Zepho. Just putting it out there, buddy. Just putting it out there. I really don't want to go back to Zepho. It is probably my least favorite place. I prefer Dathomir to Zepho, honestly.
Dathomir, huh?
It's time I faced him.
Yes. You're ready to face your past.
What about you and Trilla?
I don't know if I'll ever be ready. You know what you need to do to start healing, and I'm so proud of you for that. I have my own path.
I'm here for you if you need me.
We're about to drop out of hyperspace. Sit down.
Try this again.
We'll be fine. We'll be fine.
Ugh, thank fuck I could just climb this thing back again. Way more convenient. Oh, bounty hunters, cool. I like these guys.
It's nothing. You look small.
I got this.
That's weird. I don't think they've ever actually ambushed me here. Normally they've ambushed me in like the little arena from before. Actually, yeah, that was another thing. The detail I told you guys to remember from earlier. When Cal touched the Force Echo, and he mentioned, oh, this place used to be an arena, like all the Knight Brothers just kind of live off of toxic masculinity, I guess. But, and you see Taran Malakos is leading the Knight Brothers, and he has, like, horns on, like, a string on his, like, on his belt. It's like, it's like he fought in that arena and came out on top, basically, and now he leads the Knight Brothers. Cool detail. Very, very, very cool. Yeah, I won't be doing it on stream, but there's some really cool Force Echoes that you can check on, where you can find Taran Malakos's like crashed Jedi cruiser.
Master.
You were wrong to return here unarmed.
Not unarmed.
You think that lightsaber proves you a Jedi?
No. Facing you. Memories that have haunted me since Braca. I won't run from them anymore.
Then let us see what manner of death your courage brings. Coward! Impressive. Is power the answer?
Ah yes, T-posing Knight Brothers. Awesome.
Let's go.
Just go straight on? Do I have to climb that? Or oh, okay, cool. It's literally just through here. I mean, I'm sure the thing that's up there is something that I found already, just like a chest or something like that. And looks like this is New Game Plus, hence all of the cosmetic items that I do have.
You chose to return. Brave. But not wise.
Maybe. Marin, right? I'm Cal Kestis. What you were told about the Jedi was not true.
So you say, Cal. Malikos said many things too.
Terran Malikos might have been part of my order, but what he is now, I have no idea. All I do know is having a lightsaber isn't what makes you a Jedi.
Then what does?
We were peacekeepers. We were betrayed by those we protected. Hunted down by the Empire. I might be one of the last of my kind.
I was only a child when they attacked. An armored warrior brandishing this descended upon us. And cut down my people, my sisters, until I was left alone with the dead. Then Malikos came and promised me revenge if I shared our secrets with him in return.
I know what it's like to lose everything. And Malikos was wrong to use that against you. We don't have to be enemies.
We will need this.
There she goes again.
I'll be watching.
Let's get out of here.
Malikos lies ahead. You could turn back.
I can't. Lives are at stake.
Whose lives?
Innocents. Poor, sensitive children who will be hunted down and murdered.
As we were.
My friend, I have never been one to shy away from the pursuit of knowledge.
Alcestis!
Malikos.
Welcome home. Please begin your training. What in these ruins tempts you so much to risk death?
I could ask you the same thing.
There is power there. Beyond Jedi understanding. Power I control. I would offer you the same thing.
Don't you understand? I'm not interested in power. I want to restore the order.
Restore the Jedi Order? Oh, you poor fool. It's over! Jedi fell long before the Purge. It was stifled by tradition. Deafened by our past glories. Blinded by endless war.
Maybe. But it's never over, Malakos. We stand here now, the chance to learn. To rebuild from our mistakes.
Jedi learn. There's no future for them. Why can you not see that? It's time for something new. You and me. We could build something different. Something better.
No.
And Dathomir will be your grave. You lack finesse. Nothing, Jedi!
You have no right to Dathomir. No right to our magic. Get up, Cal Kestis. You're not dead yet.
Back, Jedi!
Malakos!
knives alive. What is this?
It's like you said, Malikosi. Dothamir will be your grave.
No!
Let him lie in the dark with his secrets until death takes him.
Why'd you help me?
To rid Dothamir of that parasite. What are you really doing here, Cal Kestis?
The ones who built this tomb, the Zepho, they created an object called the Astrium. It opens a vault on a distant planet. Inside is a list of Force-sensitive children across the galaxy. But the Empire is looking for it too.
What Empire?
The Empire. The one bent on exterminating Force-sensitive so no one can stand against it?
Then it will come for Dothamir before long, as the war did. I will help you find this Astrium.
Thank you for helping me with Malikos. Thought I was a goner for a minute.
Yes, you would have died.
Right.
I am glad you didn't. It is nice to have an ally.
Yeah, I like the sound of that.
You're welcome, Cal.
Alrighty. Just gonna save real quick. I think that might be my favorite boss battle throughout this.
This place, it's
horrifying.
Found it.
It is real.
Baron, this could be the key to the next generation of Jedi.
I'm happy for you and your Jedi. But nothing can bring back my people.
Yeah. After the Purge, I was alone for a long time. In hiding, I was scared that they'd find out who I was or what I was.
What changed?
A very good friend of mine told me to go out and find my place in the galaxy.
And you listened?
Well, no. Life has this funny way of forcing you on the path forward anyway. Now here I am. Or at least expected.
A path forward. I will join you.
You will?
I've spent years waiting for a chance to avenge my sisters. I'm finished waiting. I wish to fight by your side. Night Sisters and Jedi do not travel together, but survivors, we adapt.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess we do. What do you think, BD? My crew, they might take a little bit of convincing, though.
Then we'll convince them.
Oh, shit, but...
no way forward.
There is now.
Did you raise the ones before, too?
I did. I wanted to see how you would handle mountains.
You were testing me?
And you passed.
Are you gonna help me with this?
You sure you can handle it?
Hey, BD.
Woman you travel with. Who is she?
Seer? Wait, how do you know about her?
I have seen your companions. Marikos wanted me to attack them, but they posed no threat.
Seer, well, she used to be a Jedi. It's a long story.
I would like to learn it. I'll meet you at your ship.
Feeling so great, BD.
Okay, so literally just back the way we came. It's a lot of back and forth in this game, I'll admit, but at least the scenery's pretty, right? And once again, I fall down the hole that I routinely fall down. Thought that was a force echo for a second. I was wrong.
Found it.
Oh, well, who's this? What's that supposed to mean?
It means I'll be joining you.
Seer, Grease, this is Marin.
She's a witch, isn't she?
A Night Sister. Your fear is unnecessary.
I couldn't have gotten the Astrium without her. We fought Malikos together. I trust her.
And we trust you. You will have to earn it.
Fine. Grab some seat. Didn't try anything funny.
Welcome aboard.
They like you.
I don't know what you're saying.
Where are we headed? This Cordova guy is really putting some wear and tear on my ship.
He always wanted to explore the whole galaxy.
And did you?
We explored many planets. Tombs and temples related to the Zepho and Jedi. But I hit a limit. To him, there was no limit.
The poor crazy old guy was left alone.
He was always alone, even when I was with him. He cared about his work and the future more than anything else. He didn't have the time. He was always on the move. Logano was the first place I ever saw that looked like he settled, even for a brief moment.
Agrees.
We're about to drop out of hyperspace. Sit down.
You think it'll work?
It worked for Cordova.
You can make it work.
She's right.
Oh, hey, is anybody hungry? I was thinking of whipping up some scaz steaks. I'm sorry, am I interrupting?
No, Captain. And we couldn't have gotten this far without you.
Oh. All right.
It's true, Grease.
Thank you. Hey, I hope you get in there and you find that hollow thing.
Holocron.
Are you sure it's something you should find?
What do you mean?
The children on that list. If you take them from their homes to train as Jedi, won't they be hunted like you?
It has to be kept out of the hands of the Empire.
It'll help us put an end to the Empire.
Oh, hey, change of plans, we're arriving.
Oh, Grease.
Yeah?
I take my steak rare.
Huh? Okay, now we're cooking.
Okay, so we're pretty much coming up on the end of the game, but there's still like another good, I'd say, hour and a half gameplay left, so I think I might actually save that for next stream, which will hopefully be soon. I'll probably do one more of these, maybe Saturday, Sunday. That's the aim anyways, but obviously I can't make promises. Case in point, I've kind of been missing from this channel for... since Village, pretty much. I tried to stream recently enough, but I wanted to try streaming Knights of the Old Republic, but OBS did not agree with the app, like, at all. So, here we are. Yeah, this is pretty much the end half of the game. I say end half, it's like the last act of the game. After here, Pagano, it takes you to the last location. And, for anyone who hasn't been spoiled somehow miraculously by the ending, I'm gonna leave it at that and say no more regarding the ending. Alrighty, toodles.